Welcome to this tutorial on the Object Analyzer in Huygens. We will cover how to use the tool and what the main features are. The Interactive Object Analyzer tool allows you to obtain statistics of individual objects by clicking on them, or analyzing all objects with a single button press. To start the tool, simply press the magnifying glass whilst having the image thumbnail selected of the image you want to analyze. A download link to the image we are going to use is included in the video description. Working with the Object Analyzer can be divided into three steps: object segmentation, graphical manipulation, and object analysis. Note that if you change something in one of the steps, you need to redo the following steps. Step 1, the object segmentation, uses the threshold seed segmentation method. The blue lines represents the threshold. The pink line is your seed. It works as follows: if you have a line profile where the y-axis is the intensity and the x-axis is the position of your voxel, you create objects above the threshold line. Here you can see the two objects that are created when we just use the threshold. You can also use the seed line. Then the analysis will only include the objects that are above the threshold and the seed line. You can also use a garbage level, which only includes objects that are above a certain volume. There is also a third way to segment, if simple thresholds fail, in case of segmenting dim objects and separating close objects. This is called watershed segmentation. In the picture on the right, you can see that if you turn the graph upside down, it looks like a watershed, hence the name. In the object analyzer, you can visualize more than one channel. It has two surface pipes, named primary and secondary, to put image data through for object analysis. Another pipe is available to simultaneously visualize a MIP of one of the channels. In step 2, graphical manipulation, you have a couple of panels. The first one is the mode panel, where you can select the continuous state of your mouse. Here is a list of the different modes and what they do. You can find this and more about the object analyzer through the link in the video description. The second one is the single action button panel, to perform one action at a time. You can select the continuous state of your image channels, and what part of the image to apply the selected action to. Now we will present you with an example. First, we move the threshold, giving us three separate objects to analyze. If you want to make any changes to the objects whatsoever, there are helpful menus like ROI, anchors and filters, in the top left. Now you are ready to get your statistics. You can get these by clicking on an object when the magnifying glass mouse mode is enabled, or by clicking Analyze All on the top right of the statistics table. Any measured parameter can be used to filter objects out, based on geometry, distances to neighbors or references, location, colocalization and so on. If you select the row in the list of statistics, you will see the object it applies to light up, and the other way around. In the last step, you can select commonly used statistic presets by pressing the button on the top left of the statistics table. Here you are presented with a window that actually consists of three parts. You need to choose the type of preset, basic or advanced, which needs user input. You need to select the content of the preset, the location to print the result to, and so on. In the last part, there is a helpful explanation of the presets. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us.